The reaction trailing the proposed summit borders on the alleged lack of sincerity on the part of the federal government, the convener of the gathering.
The composition has shown that that summit is another grand deception, a jamboree. Obasanjo, before he left, constituted the same summit with about 150 persons with no result. And then you are now committing another summit, bringing in a northerner, somebody who have been claimed to have actually have a biased mind, even on Kensaruwa, in the issue that affected Kensaruwa in the then River State.
The money they are going to use in organizing that seminar or workshop or summit or whatever name they call it, in bringing in Gambari from America to Nigeria, is enough to put water, drinking water, electricity, the rest of it, in about 100 communities in the Niger Delta.
A kind of selective issue cannot ever work.
Some have also reasoned that if the summit must be held at all, a person from the South-South geopolitical region should head it, not Ibrahim Gambari.
Ibrahim Gambari does not know Niger Delta. And is only going to bring United Nations ideas into Niger Delta. Our demands are clear. Well, if they cannot, if we want to practice democracy in the true sense of it, we must manage our resources. And if we have to manage our resources, then we have to pay tax to the central.
Those who are the helm of affairs and the summit are deceptive. They are yet to find resolution to the Niger Delta problem.
With the situation as it is, some observers believe that only genuine commitment by the federal government to the project will douse the current opposition from the stakeholders in the oil-rich Niger Delta region. Tife Wolabi, AIT.